patient to identify the pulse of the patient, as well as some different doshas as mentioned here, Vata, Pitta and Kapha doshas. Each finger will diagnose some kind of dosha. One patent by Epson. Epson is one manufacturer which is into projectors as well as printers. So Epson has found out that an expert in Ayurveda would use his finger. Each finger will diagnose four different pulses. And so the finger should be very sensitive for the person to identify the accuracy of the pulse diagnosis. So Epson has come out with a solution by using strain sensors. These are generally used in tracks of trains to monitor the health of the tracks. When the train is passing through the tracks, certain amount of strain is transferred to these tracks and make the tracks somewhat weak. So when we find the strain of this track, we will find whether the track is healthy or not. If there is any amount of negative reading coming, we can repair the track or we can replace the track. So these strain sensors have been proposed as a solution by Epson to address the solution which problem which I have already mentioned. So here we have, suppose this is the patient's hand and this is a finger. As they have mentioned here, Epson is proposing one glove kind of thing which is equipped with strain sensors. So each finger, this is one finger, each finger will have four different sensors here placed at fixed distance. All these sensors will help the Ayurveda practitioner, even though he is not sensitive with the fingers. He can use this glove and place it on the patient's hand and then find the pulse. And then there is some signal processing going on from these strain sensors. After these strain sensors, the process signal is displayed on a display device like this. Any display device like LED or LCD device. So this is one kind of patent we have found out. And then we have Nadi Tarangini. The device is named as Nadi Tarangini by NCL, ICT and IIT Bombay. This is a collaborated invention. These people have used pressure sensors and a combination of pressure sensors and Fourier transform. Like the strain sensors, pressure sensors are also used to for health monitoring. Like pressure sensors have wide variety of applications, from finding pressure at the pump, normal tap which we use, and also finding a leak in a tank. Here we have cited one typical example where here we are measuring the pressure of a tire, and also Fourier transform. While we are communicating in our mobiles, all our voice calls are made in one particular frequency. And Fourier transform will help in translating or transforming one signal into what kind of frequency it has. When I am speaking, mine is a speech signal. There are many such signals, and each signal will have different kinds of frequencies in it. Fourier transform will help us finding all different frequencies in one signal. So, using these two, ICT and NCL and IIT Bombay have come up with one device. Here we can see this device. There is a sheet, neoprene sheet, which is attached to the hand of the patient, and then there are pressure sensors, three pressure sensors placed here, corresponding to the three fingers of the Ayurvedic practitioner. And then there is also a space between the pressure sensor and the neoprene sheet, where this place is used to inject some vacuum or inject some pressure, which is done by Ayurvedic practitioner. And then, as we have seen in the previous diagram, there is some signal processing going on, and as well as Fourier transform, and it will display the pulses or the frequencies which will help the Ayurveda practitioner to find the patient's health in a more accurate way. One US inventor has invented a tri-armed scale to identify the doshas of a person. Generally, there are three doshas, Vata, Pitta and Kapha doshas. He has invented one simple balance kind of device, each arm for one dosha. The person will be given a set of questions regarding Vata, Pitta and Kapha doshas. Like, you know, there is one kind of behavior. Suppose if you take hair is oily in Kapha dosha, if I am not wrong, for a person with body type. body type of kapha dosha. In the same way, each person will know what kind of hair he has. If the person is of kapha dosha, he will go on and add one weight here in the kapha dosha arm. And then after answering each of the sessions, there is a circular disc placed above this, which will identify which kind of body type he or she has. And then there is one Indian inventor who uses fiber optic cable to identify the pulse diagnosis instead of nadi pariksha. This is a heart rate kind of monitor, which is a belt kind of thing placed at the heart. It will transform light onto the blood, and then the reflected light is analyzed. Depending on that, the pulse diagnosis is done. There are different treatment methods. Like this is one wellness or multi-therapy system by Jeshwan Patil. He has proposed a room kind of thing which will dispel negative energy which is coming inside the room, and which will amplify the positive energy. As is shown here, the positive energy is reflected back to the jewel and is transformed to the patient. Any negative energy will be absorbed by the walls of the room or salt water pots which are placed here. And jewel radiating apparatus, as Roopashri ma'am has already mentioned, this has different crystals placed at the chakras across the person, and then light will fall onto the jewels and will reflect back onto the person for healing. And even the motion analysis and feedback has some sensors placed on the human body chakras, and then this is the amount of motion is analyzed, and then the diagnosis is done. And different dhara treatments. The thermostat is used here for maintaining the temperature in dhara treatment. So in conclusion, we would like to say that technology and Ayurveda are going hand in hand, and technology is supporting Ayurveda to make it modern and more tech friendly to the coming youth. Thank you. Ma'am, these are, as of now, what we have cited are patented inventions. Some are patented, some are still application, still going, the process is still going on. We don't know whether they are commercialized or not. It's not yet commercialized, but then we can take the interpretation, we can pay the inventor, and then we can use it.
Any idea how many of these are validated?
I mean,
how many people have used them and found them useful, laboratory?
As of now, we have not done any study on those.
At patent stage, they may not be validated.
Once it comes as a product, only then it can.
How about nadi grinding?
Yes, sir. It's
CSIR Institute and Bombay IIT. This type of thing.
Mostly it might be coming as a product, sir. We don't know the present status.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am from CSR unit for research and information products. We have created a database. I am going to just introduce about some features of this database to you. This is our team for who is working on this project. As all you all know that minerals and metals have been used anciently as a medicine. Basmas of like gold and silver are still used in Indian traditional medicines, but still it has been remained the neglected area of research due to perception of toxicity of metals. There was no mention of basmas in chemical abstract when we searched. Then with this background, we started compiling the literature on basmal. It was only in Sanskrit, and in few books of few publications, it was translated into Hindi. No English translation was available, so we collected all such literature on basmal, and then we translated it to English. Then we collected some scientific literature, published in some local journals, and some MD thesis of Jamnagar and Banaras Hindu University's university library. And then we collected, these are the basmas of metals which we have the information. When we collected this information, we found that not only in India, in all over the world, metals have been used for the treatment, for medical treatment. Lithium was used in 1859, but due to its toxicity, it lacks its further research. Again, in modern chemotherapy, after cisplatin discovery, metal discovery, again, researchers started their attention towards this thing. Then antimicrobial, silver bandages, and all those people, this research created again the interest of researchers. So we thought of creating a database of all the metals. And we found that many patents are also found, filed and granted to the worldwide research organizations and commercial organizations. So we have created a database. These are the metals. Blue red metals are the which basmas are used in the Ayurveda and Siddha medicine. And these are 55 metals are included in our database. We have reviewed the patents and literature for last 50 years. We have about 2,700 unique records from patents and peer-reviewed journals. Out of this 2,700, 690 are only patents. And it includes metals for treatment of diseases as well as diagnostics agents. It includes the clinical trials, toxicology studies on human as well as animals. From our study, we found out that zinc, iron, copper, gold, and magnesium are most studied metals. And boron, radium, technetium are the diagnostic agents. This you can see the metal-wise patent analysis. Zinc is the maximum used patented metal. These are the top 10 diseases you can see where patents have been filed or where metals have been used as a diagnosis or for treatment. This is our database. We can retrieve our database with browse option, simple search and advanced search. Browse option, we have the, you can select from metal name, drop down list of metal name, disease name or mechanism action of that or diagnostic agent. Once you select that, the any metal, you will get the list of journals or patents available in the database. This is our simple search. You can select the field of your search and you can give keter and you will get the result. This is advanced search where you can get the combination. You can combine with AND and OR options. We can combine our fields and we can get this. And this is what finally you will get the record. With bibliographic details, you will find the abstract, whether it is a research article or patent, you will find the bibliographic data. Now, what our finding was, metal itself can be effective as a therapeutic role like platinum. It can serve as a carrier to pharmaceutical active molecules like boron. It can substitute the organic drug like selenium and silicon. Then some metals are like essential metals which are required for normal functioning of protein and enzymes like iron and zinc. And some metals can be used as a diagnostic agents. In diagnostic agents, again, it can be used as a imaging probes, molecular imaging or contrast agents. Some metals have been used as a non-invasive radiopharmaceuticals like isotopes of cobalt, gallium and rhodium. And some have been used for boron neutron capture theory for brain tumors diagnosis. What our research work find out that metals, some metals have been already established as a drugs, like gold has been used for arthritis and platinum for cancer. Now researchers are trying to find out to make the new complexes or to try the complexes and compounds of these metals for another diseases like cancer and tropical diseases. Another is researchers are trying to balance the therapeutic effect and toxicity of drugs like arsenic oxide treatment is being trying for the leukemia. Then Wilson disease, which is occurs because of copper poisoning, can be treated with zinc supplements. Some researchers are trying like tin porphyrin, which porphyrin, which is a novel metal based drugs. It has been tried for the age related macular degenerated. And some new paramagnetic agents like gadolinium and manganese have been tried for the as a contrast agents in MRI applications. What researchers are trying to do? Researchers are trying to understand the fundamental of chemistry of how these metals are working in the body of the patient. So they are trying with new applications or new metals. They are trying with as a contrast agents. Like now they are tried for lithium complexes for Alzheimer's diseases. They are trying to find out the mechanism action for these complexes like platinum complex, like cisplatin is well known as for anti-cancer. But now they are trying to find out the new drugs having the similar structure, the new molecules. Then they are trying to find the second and third generation drugs. Researchers are trying to do. one of our attempt is to linking the traditional knowledge to the modern medicine. Gold nanoparticles was tried by Dr. Murali Shastri in NCL. He tried to make this gold particle by using the procedure of Ayurveda Bhasma procedure, of Suvarna Bhasma procedure. And nearby that year only, Dr. Mitra has tested the toxicity study of Suvarna Bhasma. And she had found that no toxic results were reported for this Suvarna Bhasma. So we are trying to establish the correlation between the nanoparticle size and Bhasma size. And we are trying to link in the tradition. What is the benefits of this database? This here will get all the integrated data of traditional medicine as well as the modern medicine, including scientific literature and patent literature. We are trying to linking the knowledge with the traditional knowledge with modern science. One PCT application has been already filed for a patent on Bhasma. If we create a such database, we can even prevent such applications by opposing this database. And in future, we are planning to add more minerals like Mauktik Bhasma, which is pearl Bhasma, and Prawal Bhasma, which is coral Bhasma, to in our database. And thank you for DSR for supporting us on finance.
Good morning, everybody. I am Sivkami Dhulap from CSR Yurde. Today I am going to present statistical analysis of all the bioevaluation studies of medicinal plants commonly used in Ayurveda. I'll not go into in-depth into the details of the introduction. All of us are in this room are aware that medicinal plants, they are an important constituent of most of the traditional medicinal systems. Till today they are regarded to be safe, and hence all of us are finding that we should widely make use of these traditional medicines even today, and mainly we want to use them in these along with the modern medicines, and mainly to address the newly occurring diseases associated with the lifestyle or the environmental issues. Many of the researchers, as we have seen in the morning, many of the researchers have already started investigating what is the role of the medicinal plants, especially with the mechanism of action, to understand the mechanism of this action so that it can be integrated in today's medicine. What we have explored that right from 1960 itself, the researchers have been exploring and investigating the role in terms of the mechanism of action, the herb-herb interaction, herb-drug interaction, and all of these are published. But